found a little book in a used bookstore. It was $1.50, it was a used book. And I opened it to the first page, and the first words in the book were, "There is an island where rivers run deep, where the sea sparkling in the sun earns it the name Jewel of the Antilles." And I went, "Oh, it's a musical," you know, because the language was so beautiful. And I bought it for $1.50 and read it in an hour and rushed it over to his apartment in a cab, and that became Once on This Island.
I was really excited about the notion of creating the musical language of this fictitious island that was neither Haiti nor Jamaica. It was really a place of its own. So really, I used a lot of Afro-Caribbean music in that, but I also used a lot of South American beats, you know, the beats of the samba find their way into the score. And so really creating a world that didn't exist before, using all of these elements, it just became this amazing gumbo of a score, and I loved every minute of it. And actually, of all the scores we've written, that was the fastest writing we've ever done. We wrote the entire show in 6 months. So even though it was like a sort of very much an experimental piece for us, I think we were really connected in a deep way with that particular story.
There's something about Once on This Island that is almost indefinable, that affects everyone who performs that show or sees the show. There's something life-changing about it, and I take no credit for it. I don't think it's what we wrote exactly. There's something about the idea of a young girl who is ready to leave her parents and go off into the world to find her love, for better or for worse, and her parents must relinquish her to the world to make her own mistakes. And there's something so profound about that. And when the ending isn't entirely happy, nevertheless, she changes the world by what happens to her. The world is changed, and people of different persuasions and different skin colors are brought together under this miraculous tree that is the ending of the show. It is a fairy tale for our times. It has a healing property that is like a little bag of herbs that you hand over a school or somebody performs it and they come out changed. It's uncanny. Don't ask me. It's just part of the story.
I think there's something that the score is infused with love. That's all I can say. I was in love for the first time whenever I was writing that particular score. I also went through a really difficult thing with a friend of mine, and it was a health crisis, and there was a lot, the stakes were so high, I mean, for me personally, and I think that's the first time where I was able to really put my emotional life into music, and music was a receptacle, and it not only made the show what it is, I personally was healed by writing that show, and I think that the residue of that experience is right in those notes, and I think everybody that comes into contact with it feels that, and I think it's because it's real.